Vantablack is one of the most mysterious substances on the planet. It's so dark that when it's applied to any object, it makes that object look 2D. It's been put on sculptures, high-end watches, and even an entire BMW. So what exactly is Vantablack, and why is it so expensive? Vantablack is one of the darkest materials ever created. The distinction for the darkest material goes to something called Blackest Black. This was created by MIT scientists in 2019 using carbon nanotubes. But let's get back to Vantablack. The reason why it gives off such a deep black is because it absorbs 99.965% of light. People often compare it to a black hole, which absorbs all light. Black holes don't let a single photon escape. So how come, when you look at something covered in Vantablack, it looks 2D? And why can something coated in Vantablack be a big safety issue? Our eyes send 2D images to the brain. Depth perception is what makes those images look 3D. Another way we can tell things are 3D is through shading. Take this basketball, for example. We can tell it's 3D because of the shades of light on different parts of the ball. Once Vantablack is applied, almost no light is reflected back to our eyes at all, which makes it look two-dimensional. So what makes Vantablack so dark in the first place? It's because the material is made up of carbon nanotubes, just like Blackest Black. The only difference between Blackest Black and Vantablack is the arrangement of the nanotubes. Once light hits a group of these tubes, it will bounce between them and eventually get converted into heat, making light completely disappear. One nanotube is only a few nanometers in diameter, which is around 25,000 times smaller than the width of a sheet of paper. Unlike what most people think, Vantablack can't just be painted on. Instead, the carbon nanotubes are grown onto the target object, just like a field of grass. The tubes are grown at a temperature of 752 degrees Fahrenheit. Surrey Nanosystems took advantage of this technology and invented what we now know as Vantablack. The carbon nanotubes that make up Vantablack are actually what give it its name. Vanta is an acronym for vertically aligned nanotube arrays. With all this in mind, you may be wondering, what does Vantablack feel like? According to Steve Northam of Surrey Nanosystems, it doesn't really feel like anything at all. It's as if you're touching any other smooth surface. But even though it feels smooth as silk, you wouldn't want to touch it. That's because the material is made from millions of microscopic nanotubes that are essentially sticking out. Almost any form of contact will ruin the arrangement, and of course, light will start reflecting. Unfortunately, this means Vantablack isn't quite ready yet for things such as cars and clothing. While Vantablack is undeniably cool to look at, it actually also has some practical applications. It can cut back on light interference, making it highly useful for space exploration and long-distance telescopes. Dark coatings on the inside of telescopes work to absorb unwanted light before it hits the camera. Vantablack absorbs 17 times more light than the inside lining of the Hubble telescope, which was launched in 1990. With this new technology, we will be able to more accurately measure things in outer space. Vantablack could also be used to create real-life invisibility cloaks, disguising soldiers or aircrafts as ambiguous black shapes to help them stay hidden. Another use for this super black is in satellites. Elon Musk's Starlink received a lot of complaints from the science and astronomy communities, saying that their satellites were interfering with the observation of outer space. To solve this problem, Starlink's solution was to apply a coat of super dark material to the satellites, similar to Vantablack, that way they blend in with the background. Unsurprisingly, the art world has also found many uses for Vantablack. One of these artists is Anish Kapoor, who uses it to craft mesmerizing sculptures and even high-end timepieces. Kapoor made a deal with Surrey Nanosystems and now owns the exclusive rights to the artistic use of Vantablack. This was highly controversial and even caused other artists to create their own super black. Although Kapoor owns the exclusive rights to the first version of Vantablack, other artists have been able to use new forms of Vantablack to create masterpieces. One example is the Vantablack Pavilion that was unveiled for the 2018 Winter Olympics in Pyeongchang. It's no surprise the host country of a Winter Olympics will pull out all the stops to bring the world's attention to the games. Architect Asif Khan did just that with his Vantablack Pavilion for Pyeongchang. The so-called darkest building on Earth looked just like negative space against the winter sky in Pyeongchang. The Vantablack Pavilion was nearly 33 feet high and 115 feet long. You might be wondering, if Vantablack is so sensitive and hard to work with, how is an entire building actually coated with the stuff? Khan used Vantablack VBX2, which is Vantablack but specifically made for these types of applications. Khan added small lights to the pavilion that mimicked stars. This gave the building an appearance similar to outer space. Although Khan was able to construct his architectural masterpiece using Vantablack, other artists weren't so lucky. Anish Kapoor's sole artistic ownership of Vantablack sparked an outrage in the creative world. Plenty of other artists wanted to use the revolutionary material to create their own mesmerizing masterpieces. Stuart Semple is one of Kapoor's biggest critics. With Kapoor hogging the use of Vantablack, Semple decided to get creative and make his own version of the material, Black 2.0 and Black 3.0.
The final version of Black 3 that we finished this morning.
While these colors don't have the same light-absorbing power as the original Vantablack, they are still super dark, and anyone in the world can use them, unlike Vantablack. Semple also produced the Pinkest Pink, which is a fluorescent, ultra-saturated pink that Kapoor can't use under strict instructions from the creator. In retaliation, Kapoor posted a picture of himself with his middle finger dipped in Pinkest Pink, sticking straight up at the camera. In Massachusetts, Nanolab and artist Jason Chase produced a new jet-colored substance called Singularity Black, aimed at opening up access to the dark material and giving artists a chance to use it in their artwork. Many people in the artistic community see Vantablack's exclusivity as a slap in the face to their art form, since they are free to use almost any other substance in the world. Despite this, Kapoor has repeatedly defended his position. He said the reason why it's exclusive is because it's a collaboration. He argues that it's just like any collaboration, such as the artists he's worked with that have exclusive rights to certain stainless steel. As for Surrey Nanosystems, they're on Kapoor's side, and they've turned other artists away. Vantablack's appeal is partly related to its price tag and partly related to its otherworldly quality. In a world full of color, the almost complete absence of it can make any product stand out. Luxury automaker BMW was one of the first to get their hands on the product. They unveiled its X6 models covered fully in Vantablack paint during the Frankfurt Auto Show in September of 2019. The floor model was coated in Vantablack, but BMW made it clear that it wouldn't be mass producing a line of Vantablack covered cars. That's because of all the safety issues we alluded to earlier. Imagine seeing a two-dimensional shadow coming at you at night, and you can't tell how close or far away the shadow is. The only clue would be seeing floating headlights. That's what encountering the BMW would feel like. Although car buyers are unlikely to buy a Vantablack BMW anytime soon, you can get your hands on a watch covered in it. H. Moser & C., one of the top Swiss luxury watchmakers on the planet, incorporated Vantablack into one of their watch designs, listed at a price of $75,000. The watch's Vantablack is directly applied straight from the engineers at Surrey Nanosystems and then sent back to H. Moser & C. for the finishing touches. H. Moser & C.'s masterpiece is known as the Endeavor Tourbillon Concept Vantablack. There are only 50 in circulation, making this timepiece one of the ultimate status symbols. H. Moser & C. played around with different versions, too, creating a Vantablack-tinged watch encrusted with diamonds for $54,000, and a simple Vantablack watch, retailing for just $27,600. With Vantablack competitors quickly jumping onto the market, it's likely that you can get a watch in Singularity Black or Black 3.0 for a fraction of the price. Chronotechnica has made a Blackest Black watch that was listed for just $500. They won't release any information on what material is used to make it look so black. With all that being said, how much does pure Vantablack actually cost? Unfortunately, Vantablack isn't sold to private individuals. Instead, it's reserved only for research or educational groups. On Surrey Nanosystems' official website, you can purchase a 6-square-inch sample, costing around $366. What about the alternatives? Stuart Semple's Black 2.0 is on sale for around $16 for 5 ounces. Black 3.0 costs $22 for the same amount. Although they aren't quite as dark as Vantablack, these substitutes can be bought by just about anyone. Except for Kapoor, of course. Vantablack is one of the darkest shades of black, but as we said earlier, there's something even darker. Engineers at MIT actually developed Blackest Black using carbon nanotubes similar to Vantablack. Amazingly, the engineers found it completely by accident. They were trying to grow carbon nanotubes on aluminum, but they realized that oxide was forming when the material was exposed to air. To fix this, they added salt to dissolve it. Then they removed the oxygen from the air and grew the nanotubes by heating it in an oven. To their surprise, the color came out to be a super deep black. After testing, they found that it only reflected 0.005% of light, which makes it 10 times darker than Surrey Nanosystems Vantablack. MIT artist Damit Streba took advantage of this newfound black and used it to create a piece called The Redemption of Vanity. This exhibit contained a $2 million yellow diamond covered in Blackest Black. Why would anyone cover such an expensive diamond in something that would hide its shiny characteristics? Straba said that the piece is, quote, presenting the literal devaluation of a diamond, which is highly symbolic and of high economic value. Scientists are still working to find an even darker material. As for right now, it's unlikely that we'll see any products for sale coated in Vantablack, simply because of its brittle structure and high price tag. As for right now, its practical uses are only in things such as sensors, cameras, and even telescopes. Will we ever find a material that absorbs 100% of light?